नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग. यू आर वॉचिंग राज्यसभा टेलीविजन. आई एम स्मृति रस्तोगी विद न्यूज टुनाइट. लेट्स बिगिन द बुलेटिन विद द टॉप हेडलाइंस. राज्यसभा पासेस बिल टू एक्सटेंड प्रेसिडेंट्स रूल इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. अप्रूव्स बिल टू प्रोवाइड रिजर्वेशन टू रेजिडेंट्स लिविंग अलोंग इंटरनेशनल बॉर्डर इन द स्टेट. यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर अमित शाह आस्क्स व्हाई डिड नेहरू गवर्नमेंट गो टू द यूएन डिस्पाइट कश्मीर एक्सेशन टू इंडिया. Why did he agree for the plebiscite? That is out of the question today. Lok Sabha passes Central Educational Institutions Reservation in Teachers Cadre Bill 2019. Bill provides 10% quota for economically weaker sections in recruitment of teachers in higher educational institutions. Enforces SC, ST and OBC reservation in universities as a single unit instead of department level. Good news on economic front. 8 core sector industries record growth of 5.1% in May compared to 4.1% in the same period last year. Steel and electricity output increased 19.9% and 7.2%. In 2 years of GST, revenues of 20 states have gone up 14%, says Arun Jaitley. Former Union Finance Minister indicates that upon further increase of revenues, 12 and 18% slabs could be merged. And NDA government launches countrywide water conservation campaign with emphasis on 1592 stressed blocks in 256 districts. Jal Shakti Abhiyan to focus on rainwater harvesting, renovation and recharging of water bodies, reuse of water, watershed development and intensive afforestation. The Rajya Sabha passed the Jammu and Kashmir Reservation Amendment Bill 2019. The bill has already been passed by the Lok Sabha. The upper house also approved the statutory resolution to extend president's rule in the state for a further 6 months with effect from 3rd July 2019. Union Home Minister Amit Shah moved the bill in the Rajya Sabha. The approval for the resolution and the amendment bill was given by the voice vote amid protests from the Congress and some opposition parties. The Union Minister said that the Jammu and Kashmir Reservation Amendment Bill will provide 3% reservation to people who live along the line of control, line of actual control and international border. He mentioned that over 3.5 lakh people will benefit from the bill. Requesting the extension of President's rule, Home Minister Amit Shah said, the legislative assembly elections in Jammu and Kashmir will be held in a democratic, free and fair manner once Election Commission announces the election schedule for the state.
हम नेहरू जी के बारे में कोई गलत विचार देश की जनता के बारे में खड़ा करना नहीं चाहते, देश की जनता को गुमराह भी करना नहीं चाहते. ना ही हमारा मकसद है ना हो सकता है, परंतु एक बात है, इतिहास की भूलों से जो देश नहीं सीखते हैं उनका भविष्य अच्छा नहीं होता है. इतिहास की भूलों की चर्चा होनी चाहिए, मगर इतिहास के अंदर अच्छी लगे वो बातें बता देना और जो अपने लिए अच्छी न हो वो बातों को छिपा देना, मैं मानता हूं इस सदन के अंदर माननीय अध्यक्ष जी ये नहीं करना चाहिए. हमारी सरकार सुरक्षा के लिए कटिबद्ध सरकार है. मैंने पहले ही कहा कि आतंकवाद के लिए जीरो टॉलरेंस की नीति लेकर हम चलते हैं. हमने आज तक सबसे ज्यादा सीआरपीएफ की कंपनियां भी वहां पहुंचाई है और सीआरपीएफ की जम्मू कश्मीर में जो कंपनियां हैं उनको आधुनिक साधनों से लैस करने का भी प्रयास किया है। जमायत इस्लामी, इसको भी संरक्षण प्राप्त था, राजनीतिक संरक्षण, दल का नाम देना नहीं था, परंतु राजनीतिक संरक्षण प्राप्त है कहने में मुझे कोई हिचकिचाहट नहीं है, मगर उस पर भी हमने प्रतिबंध लगाया। जमीनी स्तर पर आतंकवादियों को समर्थन करने वाले लोगों के प्रिएंटिव अरेस्ट किए गए, जेलों की चरमराई हुई व्यवस्था को अत्याधुनिक कर कठोर से कठोर तरीके से जेलों के अंदर से जो टेररिज्म को बढ़ावा दिया जाता था उसको हमने बंद किया। उसके बाद कैदियों को असंगठित करने के लिए बहुत लंबे समय के बाद।
Meanwhile, members from several political parties in the Rajya Sabha participated in the discussion.
क्या वजह है कि इन्हीं 5 सालों में सबसे ज्यादा हमारी फौजी मारे गए? क्या वजह है कि सबसे ज्यादा सिविलियन इन्हीं इसी वक्त में मारे गए? क्या वजह है कि हमारे आर्मी, मेरे लिखे हैं, मैं नाम नहीं लेना चाहूंगा, 16 आर्मी सीआरपीएफ के जो इंस्टॉलेशन है वो उड़ी से लेकर नगरोटा से लेकर जितने बड़े बड़े इंपॉर्टेंट जगह हैं उन पे हमले हुए और लोग हमारे फौजी मारे गए। सिर्फ हमले नहीं हुए, मारेगे भी। अगर ये जीरो टॉलरेंस है तो ये 16 हमले कहां से आए, क्यों हुए और हमारे फौजी क्यों इनमें मारे गए?
आप लोगों के अपने फैसलों की वजह से, आप लोगों की जो तंग नजरी है उससे एक वजह की वजह आज जम्मू कश्मीर के ये हालात हो रहे हैं। इसलिए ये कहना कि वहां पे कोई गवर्नमेंट नहीं बना सकता था, ये भी गलत बात है, ये भी हाउस को मिसलीड करने की बात है।
तो यदि जम्मू कश्मीर को बदलना चाहते हैं तो आपको राजनीतिक चश्मे से उसे देखना बंद करना पड़ेगा।
आतंकवाद का समर्थन करने वालों को आप कश्मीर की धरती पर कोई ठिकाना नहीं है, अपना अपना बोरिया बिस्तर बांधे होकर जम्मू कश्मीर को अपना
पार्टी ने दिया उसी।
तो अब परिस्थिति कश्मीर में ये है कि राष्ट्रपति शासन लागू है, कल खत्म हो जाएगा और चुनाव कोई एक दिन में हो नहीं सकते, इसलिए आपने परिस्थिति ऐसी पैदा कर दी कि हम उसका समर्थन करें ही, इसलिए मैं इस अध्यादेश का समर्थन करता
हूँ। यू आर आस्किंग मी व्हाई आई ऑल्सो डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू Hindu, Muslim, no sir, Indian citizen. Now let me tell you about the second bill, the resolution I said we are supporting. And the second bill which you are bringing for the third kind of border, the international border. There also from the Trinamool Congress, we are supporting this. Because we believe Indian citizen must be given the benefit. Indian citizen must be given as many rights. So I ask this government through you,
it is better to have instability in the political system in a state like Jammu and Kashmir than President Sul. So in that circumstances, we invite or we support President Sul because we hope there should be some sort of stability. But my question, as it has been raised by some other honourable members, sir, when the situation was conducive to hold the parliament election, why it was not conducive to hold the assembly election simultaneously?
इसी नोट अब अपने केस को मजबूती से रखते, ये गलतियां हुई हैं। फिर जब कश्मीर हमारा हिस्सा हो गया तो किसने कहा आपको प्लेबिसाइट ऑर्डर करने के लिए? प्लेबिसाइट आपने ऑर्डर किया, उतना ही नहीं, आपने कहा प्लेबिसाइट भी होगा और इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन मतलब यूएनओ के अंडर होगा, इतना ही नहीं, जरा रिकॉर्ड देख लीजिएगा। आपकी इच्छा ये भी थी कि इसको हम लोग इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस में ले जाए। ये सब मुद्दे हैं, इस पर जवाब दीजिएगा। लेकिन मैं इस बात के लिए सरकार को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूं कि आपने आरक्षण का मुद्दा कश्मीर में बढ़िया से लागू किया है, इसके तहत काम कराइए, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
यू वांट द कश्मीर इश्यू टू बी कंटिन्यूड फॉर योर पेटी पॉलिटिकल गेन्स, सर यू हैव टू यूनाइट द पीपल। इफ यू आर सीरियस इन रिजॉल्विंग द कश्मीर इश्यू, यू हैव टू यूनाइट द पीपल टू फाइट टेरर, बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली you are dividing the people on communal lines.
That we must look at Jammu and Kashmir as one entity which includes Ladakh, which includes Jammu. Sir, some people would say, oh, this is actually communalizing the whole thing. But it is something, what happens in Kashmir affects us deeply And therefore, it's very glad that a passionate debate of this nature is actually being held. And I think that national consensus which we have managed to actually forge, and it's important to bring out these trends.
आपको रियल पोजीशन देखनी पड़ेगी वहां जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों के साथ. मेरी गुजारिश है होम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया से, मेरी गुजारिश है प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया से कि यहां से जो बाहर में लेफ्ट में है, जो राइट में, जो भी है, कुछ एमपीज हमारे साथ आए. हम दो एमपी है. गांव गांव में देख लीजिए आप कि लोगों में जख्म कैसे लगे. हिंदुस्तान के खिलाफ लोग नहीं है. आपको वो देखना पड़ेगा कि हिंदुस्तान को कौन कमजोर कर रहा है. वो ऐसी सिचुएशन है. हमारे लोगों को कौन बॉर्डर पर मार रहा है
कि जम्मू कश्मीर की रक्षा करने के लिए वहां के जो हमारे पुलिस बल के जवान शहीद होते हैं. मैं गृह मंत्री जी को बधाई देना चाहता हूं कि उन्होंने उनके घर जाकर के उनके मनोबल को बढ़ाया. और आज हमारी सरकार जम्मू कश्मीर के लोगों की सुरक्षा के लिए प्रतिबद्ध है. और इसलिए वहां पर जाकर जम्मू कश्मीर के सामाजिक संगठनों के साथ भी बात करी. और आज जो जम्मू कश्मीर के हालात बने हैं, हमारी सरकार के प्रयासों से जम्मू कश्मीर में सब प्रकार की घटनाओं में जो उग्रवाद की घटनाएं हैं उसमें कमी आती है.
सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विल इफेक्टिवली वर्क इन द स्टेट एंड द आर्मी विल गेट फ्रीडम टू कैरी ऑन द ऑपरेशंस टू ड्रैग आउट द टेरर फोर्सेस फ्रॉम कश्मीर. सो governor's rule will bring with itself the pressure of re-elections from the various opposition parties also, but the governor's rule is necessary.
And I oppose this extension of period. Of course, the reservation I welcome, but I am against the ordinance route. Anyhow, that is a welcome measure that will do good to the people of Kashmir, but extension of President rule is against democracy, against all natural law.
हमेशा गोलाबारी, सीज फायर, उनका नुकसान होता है. मरते हैं लोग, फिर भी वो लोग बॉर्डर में रहते हैं, हिंदुस्तान जिंदाबाद के नारे देते हैं और हमारा हौसला बढ़ाते हैं. हम उन लोगों को सैल्यूट करना चाहिए. उनको रिजर्वेशन उनका हक और होना चाहिए.
कंड्यूसिव एटमोसफियर and violence is unabated, and as such the atmosphere is not conducive to hold the elections. Therefore it has to be extended. Second point, number 2, assembly has been dissolved. It is not in suspended animation. Therefore there is no way that two or more political parties can come together and form the government at this point of time.
आपने भी यही बात कही है कि हम इलेक्शन के लिए तैयार हैं. इलेक्शन कमीशन हमसे जब कहेगा तो हम इलेक्शन के लिए तैयार हैं. तो अगर ये स्थिति थी तो ऐसा क्या बीच में स्थिति आ गई कि इलेक्शन वहाँ पर विधानसभा के नहीं हो सके जबकि अन्य जगह पर हुए? तो ऐसा कौन सा क्या कारण था? क्योंकि ये मानना ज़रा सा मुश्किल है, गले से नहीं उतरता कि इलेक्शन कमीशन से अगर आप अनुरोध करें और वो आपकी बात ना माने.
कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल इज दैट इट्स इन फैक्ट इन द प्रीएम्बल दैट जम्मू कश्मीर इज एन इंटेग्रल पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया. देयर इज नो डिस्प्यूट ऑन दैट इश्यू. So these points make all these opposition totally irrelevant.
Meanwhile, the Rajya Sabha chairman made important observations to enhance the productivity and efficacy of the House on Monday. Take a look at this report.
Chairman Naidu made important observations in the upper house on Monday, asking members to keep zero hour submissions specific and latest.
If zero hour, you give notice on general issues, that we will not be able to get justice to that one. Secondly, I have to think about, but the other day while making an observation, I said not only special mention but also zero hours also has to be responded by the ministers. The practical difficulty that is coming is if you make a general observation, then there will be, we have taken note, it is under consideration, or it will be examined. Only it will be like that only. So zero hour submission should be latest one. Second, it should be specific. Third, it should not be matter concerned with the state government, because at the end of the day, states has to perform that responsibility. Central government, then you, the moment center says something, then there will be federal structure, central state relations, all these things come. And secondly, another thing, some members are very active. Good. They are giving number of notices. I have to take care of the entire house. So I have to see whether people from different parties are getting opportunity or not. So weekly once, I will see this week, this person, this member has not got any chance. So he will get priority. That I want to apprise you all of the procedure I am following. If you have not got a chance in this week, you will be the first person to get. It's not automatic, but you will be the first person to be considered. And secondly, if the time is there and members are not there, then I am moving on to special mentions also.
Chairman Naidu also underscored the importance of representation of all political parties in the House during zero hour.
And I suggest to the leader of the House and Parliament Affairs Minister to discuss among themselves and find out what will be the practical difficulty with regard to responding to zero hour submissions. And if there are any specific things that can be brought to my notice, so that we can improve upon the observation I have made. Otherwise, there will be again problems, because the moment you say something, it will go to Assurance Committee.
He also directed the government to respond to concerns raised by the members through zero hour submissions and special mentions. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
The Lok Sabha on Monday passed the Central Educational Institutions Reservation in Teachers' Cadre Bill 2019. The bill provides for filling about 8,000 existing vacancies in 41 central universities. The bill makes university or college as a unit instead of department for the purpose of providing reservation for filling teachers' posts in the central education institutions. It also provides 10% reservation for economically weaker sections. HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank said that the bill will give a major push to the reforms in the education sector, making it inclusive and fulfilling aspirations of people from different categories. The bill replaces an ordinance issued in March this year.
जनजाति और सामाजिक और शैक्षणिक रूप से पिछड़े वर्गों एवं आर्थिक रूप से कमजोर वर्गों से संबंधित व्यक्तियों की सीधी भर्ती द्वारा नियुक्तियों में पदों के आरक्षण को प्रदान करने के लिए श्रीमत, और तीसरा कि ये विधेयक केंद्रीय सरकार द्वारा स्थापित अनुरक्षित और सहायता प्राप्त केंद्रीय शैक्षणिक संस्थाओं में शिक्षकों के काडर में भर्ती द्वारा नियुक्तियों के आरक्षण प्रदान करने से संबंधित यदि देखा जाए श्रीमत, तो एक के बाद एक ये विधेयक ये साबित करता है कि यदि अंतिम छोर पर बैठे रहने वाले व्यक्ति की कोई चिंता करता है तो नरेंद्र मोदी की सरकार करती है, ये इसको साबित करता है।
Meanwhile, the HRD minister said that all private and special category schools are mandated to admit in class first or below at least 25% students belonging to weaker sections and disadvantaged groups. He said the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act came into effect from 1st April 2010, and the Act makes elementary education a fundamental right of all children in the age group of 6 to 14 years. And some more developments. Compliance audit report of the Comptroller and Auditor General of India containing audit observations on central excise and service tax revenue for the year ended March 2018 was tabled in the Parliament on Monday. CAG examined functions of central excise and service tax department relating to scrutiny, internal audit and verified records of SSEs.
The compliance audit report of the CAG containing audit observations on central excise and service tax revenue for the year ended March 2018 was tabled in Parliament on Monday. The report said that in central excise, 45,749 cases involving revenue of 1,04,718 crore rupees were pending in appeals at the end of the financial year 2018, registering a marginal decrease of 3.5% over the amount pending in 2017. In service tax, 43,718 cases involving service tax revenue of over 1,20,900 crore rupees were pending in appeals at the end of financial year 2018, registering 1% decrease over the amount pending at the end of the previous year. As on 31st March 2018, the closing balance of gross arrears was over 1,66,000 crore rupees and nearly 96,500 crore rupees for service tax and central excise respectively. However, the closing balance of arrears as per tax arrear recovery reports for March 2018 was 1,27,809 crore rupees and 85,158 crore rupees for service tax and central excise respectively. Kriti Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
A high part committee of chief ministers has been constituted for transformation for Indian agriculture. Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis will be the convener, while chief ministers of Karnataka, Haryana, Arunachal Pradesh, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh and the Union Minister for Agriculture to be the members. Niti Aayog member Ramesh Chand will be the member secretary. The committee will discuss measures for transformation of agriculture and raising farmers' income. The committee will suggest the modalities for adoption and time-bound implementation of agriculture sector reforms. The committee will submit its report in 2 months. And as the GST rollout marks its second anniversary on Monday, former Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said that 20 states have independently reported 14% rise in their revenues post the implementation of the unified tax regime. In a Facebook post, he also said that the taxpayers' base under the GST has increased 8.4% to 1.2 crore. He also suggested that 12 and 18% tax slabs in the GST could be merged going forward as revenues increase, thereby effectively making it a two-tier tax. Jaitley said that the exercise had to be done in a gradual manner. The Finance Ministry released the GST collection figures for the month of June. The total gross GST revenue collected in the month of June stands at 99,939 crore rupees. Of this, central GST is 18,366 crore rupees, while state GST is 25,343 crore rupees. Integrated GST is 47,772 crore rupees and CESS is 8,457 crore rupees. The ministry has said this in a statement. While the GST collections in the June were lower than 1,289 crore rupees in May, they were higher than 95,610 crore rupees receipts in the same month of the previous year. The eight core sector industries recorded a growth of 5.1% in May on the back of healthy output in steel and electricity. During April-May, the eight sectors grew by 5.7% compared to 4.4% in the same period last year. These eight core industries account for 40.27% of the country's industrial output. The eight core sector industries where coal increased by 1.8%, steel production by 19.9%, electricity by 7.2%, cement production by 2.8%. However, some industries like crude oil, refinery and fertilizers were in negative zone. Niti Aayog Vice Chairman Rajiv Kumar says that think tank has prepared an output-outcome framework for 162 government schemes that account for 95% of the government expenditure. The government will present this along with the union budget. In an exclusive interview with Rajya Sabha Television, Niti Aayog Vice Chairman also elaborated on the road ahead for the several sectors like agriculture and others.
For all that we have done in the last few decades, cereal production is now growing higher at a higher rate than growth of consumption. Mm-hmm. So that there are two implications of that. One, that India is probably emerging as a surplus economy in some agricultural sectors. Mm-hmm. And two, that there is a very pressing need for agricultural diversification away from only cereal and food production, food grain production, to things like marine, fisheries, poultry, horticulture, floriculture, etc. But the first one, which is the surplus status, means that we now have to focus a lot on facilitating the marketing of agriculture. And there are some laws, for example, like the the APMC Act, or the Essential Commodities Act, which need to be reviewed because they hold back our potential for exporting agricultural commodities.
Reiterating the need for a structural transformation of the agriculture sector, Rajiv Kumar added that the focus should be on diversification of crops and marketing produce that will in turn help increase farmers' income.
We have missed out on many industrial revolutions. Even the semiconductor, the internet, we were lagging behind, we are catching up all the time. This is an emerging area where countries like China have already taken a lead, but nonetheless, it's an area which is emerging all over the world. So this is one big opportunity for India to seize, that we can move to electric and connected mobility. And what we've thought is that the first step in this direction is that by 2023, there should be no more three-wheelers which are run on petrol or diesel or gas, and that by 2025, there should not be any new two-wheelers which are not electric charge.
The Niti Aayog Vice Chairman further described electric vehicle mobility as an emerging area that India needs to seize the opportunity by setting deadlines.
DMEO is now preparing what is called an output outcome framework for all the ministries. And I am very glad to say that this time the Ministry of Finance has agreed that this output outcome framework will be presented along with the budget. So that henceforth, all the ministries, and we are doing it, to begin with only for 162 main schemes, but which do account for 95% of government expenditure, that we are saying that all these schemes, we now need to know what your targets are, and now need to know also whether those targets are being achieved or not.
And you can watch the full interview with the Niti Aayog Vice Chairman on Rajya Sabha Television tomorrow night at 10 p.m. Getting you some more developments on 4th anniversary of the launch of Digital India program, Telecom and IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad said that digital technology is making lives easier for people. He said that under Digital India 2, the government would take broadband to the doorsteps in rural India through a policy push and entrepreneurship ecosystem. He stated that the government is working on creating 1 lakh digital villages. He highlighted that the government will work proactively to make India an export hub for electronics products. Prasad also said that efforts should be made to see how 5G and new technologies like artificial intelligence can be leveraged under Digital India.
Digital village ek autonomous digital unit hogi. Jahan Wi-Fi bhi hoga, healthcare bhi hoga, सीएससी कनेक्ट भी होगा, एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप भी होगी. तो जहाँ जहाँ डिजिटल विलेज अभी स्थापित किया है वहाँ सफलता मिली है, इसको और आगे बढ़ाना है. तो दैट इज हाउ द होल थिंग गो. मूवमेंट को और इंक्लूसिव बनाएं और गांव के बच्चे, देश के बच्चे, छोटे शहरों के बच्चे लो कॉस्ट प्रोडक्ट लेकर के आएँ फॉर एग्रीकल्चर केयर, फॉर हेल्थ केयर.
And with several parts of the country reporting a water shortage, the government has launched a water conservation campaign, Jal Shakti Abhiyan. Union Jal Shakti Minister Gajendra Singh Shekhawat launched a campaign with an emphasis on 1,592 stressed blocks in 256 districts. The Jal Shakti Abhiyan will focus on 5 aspects: water conservation and rainwater harvesting, renovation of traditional and other water bodies, reuse of water and recharging of structures, watershed development and intensive afforestation. In urban areas, plans with time-bound targets will be developed for wastewater reuse, for industrial and agricultural purposes. In a tweet, Prime Minister Narendra Modi urged the people to support the Jal Shakti Abhiyan. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Thank you for watching. Namaskar. We'll be right back.